What image comes into your mind when you think of a water monster? The Goliath tentacle-wielding kraken? Or something more reptilian? I'm guessing it would probably be a big creature with big teeth. Something similar to the classic image of Nessie or sea serpents with long, slender necks? Perhaps something like a plesiosaur from ages past fits the bill. Long neck and sharp teeth, with many species larger than any human. But what if there was something else? Something that hunted plesiosaurs. In 2009, a team from Oslo University traveled deep into the north to the isolated island of Spitsbergen in the hunt for monsters. They had to go armed as the island is also home to the world's largest land carnivore, the polar bear. They weren't there for the polar bears, though. They were searching for a much bigger predator, one that was buried in the earth. You see, this small island was a gold mine for fossils. Team leader Jorn Hurum described it as like a gold rush. There are so many fossils waiting to be found. A great place to have a dig. There's a problem though, and it's not just the prowling polar bears. Spitsbergen can get pretty cold. In winter, the temperatures can drop to negative 30 degrees Celsius. With only a few short weeks in summer to work before the ground freezes over, the team had to dig hard and fast, while keeping an eye out for the bears. And then, in 2009, they found their monster, a very large reptile. The name Spitsbergen means pointed mountains, and it is the largest island of Svalbard. But if we go back 150 million years, Spitsbergen was a shallow sea packed with marine reptiles. 250 million years ago, life on this planet was changed forever. The Permian mass extinction wiped out 70% of terrestrial species, and more than 96% of the planet's marine species were erased. The oceans warmed up, making it an ideal time for the cold-blooded reptiles to invade. The low oxygen content of the water made it difficult for fish to thrive, but it was no problem for the reptiles that would surface to breathe air. This is known as the Mesozoic period. Reptiles ruled land and sea. Though there were many different kinds of reptiles dominating the ocean, there are four notable predator groups. Meaning fish lizard, ichthyosaurs had streamlined bodies resembling what some of our modern-day fish look like. They were built for speed. Despite the physical resemblance, though, they possessed no gills, being reptiles, of course, and still had to surface for air. Appearing in the Triassic, they became most diverse in the Jurassic, before dying out in the Cretaceous. The aforementioned plesiosaurs, usually known for their long neck and small heads, weren't as fast as the ichthyosaurs, though they may have been able to make up for the lack of overall speed by being able to strike out at fish using their long neck like a snake. Speaking of the long neck, some also believe they could have used the long neck to reach down to the ocean floor in search for food, almost like a metal detector. Some of the bigger ones, like Elasmosaurus, first discovered in Kansas, could grow up to 10 meters long. Also starting in the Triassic, plesiosaurs managed to outlive their faster relatives, the ichthyosaurs, by a few million years, and made it to the end of the Cretaceous. It was during the Cretaceous period that they met their new, vicious cousin. The newest of the group, the mosasaurs, didn't come along until the Cretaceous, after the others. Though it was late, it came well armed. Similar to ichthyosaurs, they had streamlined bodies and could rapidly move through the water with ease. Lizard of the Meuse River. The Mosa stands for the Meuse River, where it was discovered in the Netherlands. Mosasaurs were apex predators, eating whatever they wanted, sometimes even each other. Being in the Cretaceous may have been fortuitous for the nimble mosasaurs, as I doubt they would have gotten on very well with their Jurassic brothers. Closely related to the long-necked plesiosaurs, pliosaurs have short necks with huge heads. They roamed the oceans during the late Jurassic period. The first was discovered by English naturalist Richard Owen in 1839. Owen is the person who coined the term dinosaur. Owen first thought the creature was a plesiosaur, but corrected his mistake a few years later. Pliosaurs were known to us for many years, but the team in Spitsbergen were about to find a new one, a big one. Working around the clock, the team unearthed fossils, and after carefully examining the jaw, vertebrae, and forelimbs, the team realized they had a new species. They had discovered Predator X, and it was big. At first, the team thought it was 15 meters, or 50 feet long, though it has been scaled down a bit to between 10 to 13 meters, so between 30 to 42 feet, which would still make it one of the biggest pliosaurs. With four large flippers, it could glide through the water with ease, though maybe not as quick and nimble as an ichthyosaur or a mosasaur. It had some other tricks up its sleeve. It's conceivable that Predator X may have been countershaded, like a great white shark. This means it would have dark colors on top, making it difficult to see from above, and light colors on the bottom, camouflaging it from below, giving it the ability to take its prey by surprise. Perhaps it kept its rear flippers in reserve, and used mostly the front ones to swim, using the back flippers as an extra turbo boost when it got close to striking. This pliosaur is also unique among pliosaurids for having longer forelimbs than other known pliosaurids. Though Predator X may have lacked a little in the speed department, it more than made up for it in raw strength. The short neck, big head, and jaws created a lethal combination of power, with some estimates putting the bite force at four times that of the mighty T-Rex, a force to be reckoned with. It ate fish, squid, and other marine reptiles, like plesiosaurs. Predator X became famous fast, with many articles reporting on this ancient sea monster, and it was featured in multiple documentaries. Eventually, Predator X got an official name, and today its scientific name is Pliosaurus funke, a titan in the ocean. The creature ruled for about 5 million years before finally becoming extinct and being buried beneath the ice.